Welcome back to Let's Play Life is Strange Before the Storm. Now beginning episode 3. Hell is empty. I'm really excited. This is, for all intents and purposes, I think it's sort of the end. But just so you guys know, I did order the deluxe edition, which has a bonus chapter with Max Caulfield in it, so I'm guessing that's more of an epilogue. Wondering if that's going to be as long as the other chapters, but anyway, yeah. I'm so excited. I'm always so excited when the new chapters come out. So episode 3, Hell is Empty, beginning.
Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm.
I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while.
I've been wondering about this.
I didn't know what it was.
There is plenty of blame to go around.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
I can't stand him.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our aerial.
No fucking chance! I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish? Yes. Let's leave. For real. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen. What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Yeah, what the hell, right? This has been killing me all this time. He's got some splaining to do.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Aww.
Of course.
Of course.
In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sera. Your birth mother.
But he was kissing her and stuff.
I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Who can really know if they're ready for that?
Chloe.
I'm here.
I'm right here. Good. I need you.
Okay. Join? I'm trying to press down instead of S. Doesn't work that way. So this is weird, like symbolic.
When I was in high school, there was one person everyone adored.
Oh, like Rachel.
Her teachers, her friends. Sera was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long.
Courtship?
She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sera wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape.
Like Rachel Amber. I'm seeing a definite comparison here between mother and daughter. Look, here it is. Well, that's her then.
When Sera became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while.
But it didn't
Becoming
last.
Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind.
Okay, so we got meeting, courtship, parenthood, descent. Sounds ominous.
However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sera, the need to escape was always there.
Oh, that kind of escape.
For over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. I was wrong.
It's like negligent.
Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. Destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything.
Well, I wonder what's wrong with her then.
The love of her own daughter.
Some kind of mental condition?
I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
Okay, this is what I really want to know. Reunion. It's been like several months now. Were they just like... I don't even remember if it was a quick kiss hello or if they were like making out or something. I don't even know. So find out.
What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel? It was true. We kissed. The saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her. That she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done. But after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. The chance to be your mother.
She squandered it. That wasn't my words. And she squandered, I was about to say.
It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again. And again, and again, to keep you safe.
But Rachel knew about this. Like, this was going on for a while, and she finally followed her father. Otherwise, how would she know?
That was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No.
Yeah.
I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
Rachel knew something was going on. That's why we were at the park in the first place.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
Yeah, right. Who says it's your decision?
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
She's old enough now.
When I left Sera, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. People change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel.
That's rough.
I think I need to lie down.
Don't fall down. Yeah, mind blown kind of moment. Is that a statue? Yes, so. Okay.
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Okay. Well, we got texts. Yeah. Alright. Mind blown, yeah. Do we read this one? I don't think so. I used to think the strangest thing about the Ambers was how normal they were. They seemed like a bad 90s sitcom family, and I did my best to play the part of the wacky yet lovable best friend. Yes, I did tag a newspaper picture of James on the fridge, but only because his face looked so stupid. The goal was to get in and out of there without causing a scene, so we could make our escape. About that. It turns out I couldn't just sit back and let Rachel's cheating father act all high and mighty. I tried to put him in his place, but it didn't really work. Then Rachel snapped. I guess she just can't stand the lying anymore. She told her mom about James making out with that woman. Everyone started yelling, and the next thing I knew, Rachel was going full Destructicon on the table. That's when the truth finally came out. Rachel's mom equals not her mom. Rachel's real mom equals makeout woman. Mind equals blown. Chloe the wacky, yet lovable. We got text. A group text. Alright, going back to the beginning. From Dana. Rachel and Chloe, where are you guys? We're at the Tempest Cast party. It's 12:40. Well, at night, in the morning. From Juliet. I already texted Rachel like 8 times. So Chloe writes, hey, I don't think we're making it. Dana says, Chloe, you should come. Heart, heart. Aiden says, yeah, Chloe. You did awesome, babe. Brooke says, hey, Chloe, great job tonight. Chloe says, thanks, I can't. Dana said, but you were amazing. Juliet said, I'll even admit that Mr. Keaton seems a little disappointed when I arrived. Dana said, seriously, just come. Aiden says, bring Rachel. Chloe says, sorry, guys. Yep, stuff pretty important right now. Got here. Yeah, Sera. What can you say about a woman so mysterious her own daughter never heard of her until now? From what James told us, Sera is a drug addict who got herself mixed up in all sorts of crazy shit. And by drugs, I mean OD and end up dead in an alleyway drugs, not smoke a bowl and watch anime. When Rachel was a baby, Sera would get high when she was supposed to be looking after her. Things got so messed up that James finally had to take Rachel away. The funny thing is, even as James talked about all the horrible things Sera had done, he still seemed, I don't know, fixated, I guess. You could see the power she had over him. Actually, when he was talking about how beloved and magnetic Sera used to be, I couldn't help think of Rachel. I wonder if James sees that too. Maybe it's what makes him so afraid of her. He's afraid of her? Anyway, now Sera is in Arcadia Bay looking to meet Rachel. After years of taking James' money to stay away, suddenly she wants a relationship with her daughter. James seems skeptical, and Rachel? I can't even imagine what Rachel must be going through. Okay. I'm not going to look at all this stuff I looked at before. At least I think I looked at it all before. You know, I'll look just in case there's something new going on.
I hope tonight hasn't messed up Rachel's memories of family trips like this.
Yeah, we got new responses, so I'll look at everything, sure.
The Tempest show feels so far away now.
I probably read this. If you guys want to pause it and read, go ahead.
This is so painful to look at.
Ditto.
This seems like a James and Rose bookshelf. I can't imagine Sera here instead.
I'm pretty sure I was using the arrow keys, the clicking and using the arrow keys. Now it's W.
Rachel only knew half the truth when she set that fire. What if she'd known everything?
I'll turn into Godzilla and destroy the whole place. I'll get this file over here.
Whoa. Sera Gearhart is a known associate of that psycho who attacked Drew. Then again, so is Frank.
I remember this. Damon Merrick, the mill, a converted lumber mill north of town, suspected of larceny, extortion, distribution, assault, robbery, and murder. Damon Merrick. So there's Sera, Peter Gillespie, Sheldon Pike, there's Frank, Francis Bowers, and Rodney Thunder Sears. I think he's the guy who was standing outside with the bouncer or doorman. Okay.
Wonder what James is thinking right now.
Well, you can find out what he's saying right now.
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sera. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
What are you afraid Sera would do?
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sera would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sera brought criminals and drug dealers into our home.
Your home? Really?
She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit.
Back then, okay.
You think Sera is involved with any of the drug dealers around here?
It wouldn't surprise me if she were. That's who she is. Chloe,
Mm-hmm.
I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
This is where I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. But please, put my daughter's safety first.
I will.
That is something I will always do.
She's so young. You are too. But I know you've experienced loss. Protect her from that. Please.
I'll do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know. Thank you.
Huh. Best conversation with him yet. Wow. So yeah, he's right, because we did see her going out of Frank's trailer, and Frank is a drug dealer.
Hard to argue that Rachel would have had a better life with Sera. But does that make what James did right?
That's one of those gray area questions. Well, this table's seen better days.
Holy shit. Rachel completely destroyed that table.
Mm-hmm. Appreciate the art.
I guess there's worse things than growing up around fancy stuff like this.
I could draw that.
It's so weird to look at this now.
Yeah, Rachel definitely looks a lot more like Sera. Makes sense.
Can't believe I was feeling goofy enough to draw that just a few hours ago. I can't even imagine how she must be feeling. Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
Oh, first name basis?
Rose.
Do you need any help?
Do you need any help with anything?
That's very kind of you. Could you get out the broom for me? It's in the breezeway, door to the left of the fridge.
Okay. I meant, like, mental help.
Were you able to find the broom?
I have not budged. Wait, so... where? Breezeway? Out here? Wait, where is it? The only... that's a window. Here? Oh, left of the fridge. You know, I never realized there was a door here. That's what threw me. Mm. I should be helping Rachel, but I guess we'll... take the thing. Room. And I want to look at that shirt.
Hey, cool graphic. Rachel was really getting rid of this?
Is that an ice cream cone with a flame in it?
Mrs. Amber, could I have this?
Oh, sure, Chloe. Rachel was going to give it away anyhow.
Thanks.
Oh, so I got another outfit then, I guess. Oh, for donation. It's mine now.
Rachel took that pretty hard. I should see if she's okay.
Alright, first broom.
Just, here you go.
Just whack her in the head with it.
Thank you. I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Aww. Me too?
I'm glad too.
You've had to cope with much worse, I know. I'm grateful Rachel has someone as strong as you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How am I doing?
Oh, your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
That's funny. I don't know. None of these really fit. It's super weird, yeah.
I guess I'm not great. Rachel and I were really happy a few hours ago, and now...
Maybe you can see why James wanted to keep this a secret. There are many painful things about Rachel's past.
Talk to him again?
Including my own role in hiding the truth.
I'm not digging with the lying stuff. Sera chose money.
Sera shouldn't have taken money over seeing her daughter.
You know, I am so thankful to her that she did. It gave me the opportunity to be Rachel's mother. I never knew how much I could love someone until I had Rachel.
But hearing the truth after all these years hurt Rachel more than anything.
I'm not happy with James for the whole way this came out.
You're not happy with James? What about what he did at the Overlook?
You're just gonna be happy about that.
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
Yeah,
you don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sera is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband.
Should you?
His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
Well, you wanted us to ask James about this? Are we supposed to talk to him again?
You're welcome to stay here as long as you need to.
Rose is so calm. Not like Rachel at all, really. I have to admit, he really cares about his daughter.
I'm depending on you to keep Rachel safe, Chloe.
Alright, yeah, he doesn't have anything else to say, so let's go up. Hello? You up there?